Hi, this video I'll show you how to construct ellipse, parabola and hyperbola by using eccentricity method. Eccentricity is defined as the ratio of distance of moving point from focus and distance of moving point from directrix. So let us consider a vertical line as a directrix line, consider as a horizontal line as a axis line. So the intersection of the horizontal line and vertical line point I consider as a directrix point, as shown here red color, and you can consider as a focus point on the axis line. So here V is a moving point. So V is a moving point for all conic sections in such a way that the eccentricity is defined. So VF divided by VD, the distance of moving point from focus, the distance of moving point from directrix. Eccentricity is always a constant. If it is less than 1, then the curve obtained will be an ellipse. If it is equal to 1, then the curve obtained will be a parabola. If it is greater than 1, then the curve obtained will be a hyperbola. Now we can see the construction of one by one. Here I am going to use new drawing tab to construct an ellipse of eccentricity value of 2 by 3. And the distance from directrix to focus 50 mm. Before start drawing, set unit and limit, then zoom all the window. So first you can draw vertical line. So approximately some convenient length you can draw it. Then draw a horizontal line as a axis line from the midpoint of. So here I am going to take some conveniently you can draw the axis line. So here I am going to, for reference, mark the directrix point and focus point. So before I am going to use a point command, change the point style. So DTP type. So you can change the point style. Then mark the directrix point of the intersection of vertical line and horizontal line. And we need to find out the focus point. The distance from directrix to focus is given 50 mm. Then draw a line on the axis line 50 mm. That end point so is called focus point. Again use point command to mention the focus point. Here I am going to use different color the points. So for directrix point I am going to use red color, and the focus point I am going to use green color. And next use divide command. Divide 50 mm line. So 2 plus 3, so 2 by 3, 2 plus 3, 5 units. So 5 equal parts I am going to divide to find the vertex point as a moving point. So 2 units from here, so 3 units from the directrix. So this is our vertex point. So consider the vertex point as a radius. We draw a circle of the radius to focus. Then draw a vertical line till the same radius. Vertically draw straight line, the same radius. So this is focus point, vertex point as a moving point, this is a directrix point. Then draw an inclined line from the directrix, so through the moving vertex point. I'm going to draw the line. So here I'm going to use a lengthen command. I'm going to lengthening of total length, type T, press enter. So here I'm going to give the value 250, press enter. So just I'm select the value, see here, based on the direction, we'll get extended of 250 mm. Then I'm going to use offset command. So I am going to offset this line 50 mm away. So you can draw the multiple vertical lines on the center line. Select the line, draw the vertical line. Okay, it's either 50 mm away or 10 mm or a convenient length. Okay, so you can draw line. So from all the line, I'm going to use a extend command. So till it touches the incline line, extend the all vertical line till it touches the incline line. Okay, now use circle command. So the first vertical line from the center line to incline line as a radius, then move a line to the focus point, the circle intersect the same radius of the line, so mark the point. Similarly, the second line comes from horizontal line to incline line. I consider as a radius, draw a circle, then select the circle, move the circle to the focus point. So the circle intersect the same radius of the line, so mark the point. Okay. Similarly, you can do for all vertical lines. Similarly, you can draw the all circle till it touches the center line, till it will intersect the circle will get intersect. So now you can see it will intersect the same line, so use point command. So next, so again use a circle command. This is a radius. Again use a circle command. So from here to here as a radius, move the circle to the focus point as a fixed point. So it will intersect the same vertical line. So follow the same procedure till it will intersect the horizontal line, Now you can see the radius of the line, it will intersect the same is not intersecting the vertical line, it intersect the horizontal line. So this is another vertex. So use point. So make it over here. Similarly, we need to do remaining half of the ellipse. So use mirror command. Okay, select the all lines. Select the all points and lines. and press enter. Then base point you can choose as this. Then another mirror end point you can choose. Now we got the ellipse circumference point. Then use spline command. So you can start anywhere. So here I'm going to start over here. So switch off the ortho mode to draw a smooth line. So zoom and pick the point. Otherwise you can we'll do some mistakes. So zoom it and select the point carefully. See here carefully, only the exact point you need to mark it. So now you can see we got the ellipse, it's a smooth curve. Then to differentiate the ellipse other than the construction lines, so I'm going to use different color as well as I'm going to use different thickness of the line. The thickness is not visible, so use a command line width. So here enable the display line width. Now it's applied. Now you can see you got the ellipse. Similar way you need to draw the based on the eccentricity value. Similar way you need to draw the parabola and hyperbola. Next, use new tab. I'm going to draw hyperbola of eccentricity of 4/3 and distance from directrix to focus 70 mm. So here draw similarly vertical line as a directrix line as convenient length. Then draw the center line from the directrix. So similarly here you can mark the directrix point and focus point. So change point style. So DT point type. So change the point type. First you can mark the directrix point. So the intersection of the center line and vertical line point is the directrix point. So distance from the directrix to focus 70 mm. So draw the 70 mm line on center line. So we got the end point. So that is nothing but your focus point. So end point is visible as a square shape. So that is the end point. This is the focus point. Now eccentricity value is given 4/3. So 4 unit from the focus, 3 unit from the directrix. So use divide command. Use divide command. Divide 70 mm line. So 4 + 3, 7 equal parts. So divide it. So here 4 units from the focus. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 units from the directrix. So 1, 2, 3. So this is our vertex point. So draw a circle. So this is our vertex point. Draw a circle of the to the focus. Consider as a from vertex to focus as a radius. Draw the circle. Then the same radius from the point you can draw the vertical line. Now we can delete the other points. Now to differentiate here you can use color. So for directrix point I'm going to use red color, and for focus point I'm going to use as a green color. Then moving point consider the same white color. So draw a inclined line. Draw a inclined line. So to the this vertical end point. So we need to extend this line. So you can use lengthen command. For the shortcut you can use LEN. So the total length we need extend convenient length. So here I'm going to extend 200 or 250 mm. So here I'm going to extend 200 mm. So the letters you can so move it. Now you can use offset command. Use offset command either 15 mm or 10 mm, that is your convenience. So I am going to use 50 mm. Okay, I'm offsetting this vertical line. So conveniently can draw after focus some lines. After focus some lines. Then you can use extend command or select the icon. Extend the all incline, all the vertical line till it touches the incline line. Till it touches the line. Okay. Now you can use a circle command. So this is the first vertical line, consider the radius. Okay. Then select the circle, move to the focus point. So the circle intersect in the same line. The circle intersect the same radius of the line, mark the points. Similarly, draw the circle of the second line. So then move the circle to the focus point. Then it will intersect the same line, so mark it, so point over there. Similarly, for all vertical lines, draw the circle. Then move the circle to the center point, so it will get intersect. So you can use point command. So next line, so move the line to the focus point, so it get intersect over here, so you can use point command. So you can conveniently you can extend off the focus 2-3 lines, that's enough, because this is an open end, we won't get closed end. When you make continuously, so if you want 200 or 300 lines, you can draw the vertical lines, then draw the circle, but it won't intersect because the eccentricity value is 4/3. To the center point, so mark the points over here. Similarly, we need to do the half of the hyperbola. So use as a mirror command, use mirror command, select the line, okay, select the line as well as the points, select the line as well as the points. Similarly, here, then press enter. So I'm going to select my base point over here. Okay, so my base point, I consider this, and another end point of the mirror line, you can consider this. So now we mirrored, then you can use spline command. Then now you can use spline command. So you can start either from top side or bottom side. So zoom it carefully. Okay. So carefully pick the points. Now we got the parabola, sorry, hyperbola, as a given eccentricity value of 4/3. So then highlight by using different color other than the construction lines, and also increase the line with to differentiate the line with. If it not visible, use line with LW command. So you can enable the display line with, then it visible. Okay, now we can draw the hyperbola of eccentricity value of 4/3. Thank you.